Shin Godzilla promotional artwork of the new Godzilla's footprint was also released, with Toho confirming that their new Godzilla will surpass Legendary Pictures Godzilla as the tallest incarnation to date. Chunichi Sports reported the size of the new Godzilla to be 118.5 meters tall, over 10 meters taller than Godzilla, but not taller than Godzilla from King of the Monsters. At the 2016 San Diego Comic-Con, it was announced that Funimation would distribute the film for North America, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean for a late 2016 release as Shin Godzilla, instead of Godzilla, Resurgence, at the insistence of Toho. In early September, Funimation officially announced that the film was to be given a one-week limited release in the United States and Canada from October 11 to 18 on 440 screens, in Japanese with English subtitles, making it the first Japanese Godzilla film to receive a theatrical North American release since Godzilla 2000. In Japan, Shin Godzilla earned 625 million yuan on its opening weekend and was number one at the box office for that weekend, placing Finding Dory at second place and One Piece film, Gold at third place, and earned 23% more than 2014's Godzilla when it opened in Japan. The site's consensus reads, Godzilla, Resurgence offers a refreshingly lo-fi, and altogether entertaining, return to the monster's classic creature feature roots. On Metacritic, the film has a score of 67 out of 100 based on 14 critics, indicating generally favorable reviews. Japanese pop culture site RO65 called the film a masterpiece of unprecedented filmmaking, and felt that the film retains a strong respect for the fundamental message within Godzilla. Brian Ashcraft from Kotaku felt the film was a letdown, though he praised the film's special effects and social reflection of Japan. He criticized the film's depiction of the human characters, stating, I wish the movie explored the relationships between the politicians and the researchers more instead of glossing over it, and concluded that this isn't one of the best Godzilla films ever made, but it's certainly not one of the worst by any stretch, either. Godzilla, Resurgence is a series of compelling ideas in a so-so Godzilla movie. Ollie Barta from Forbes was surprised at how good the film was, praising Anno's classic Gainax motifs, though he was not completely fond of Godzilla's new design. He felt that the googlet eyes made Godzilla look silly but that the design was more organic and menacing than previous incarnations, and praised the film's depiction of Godzilla, stating, I really like the way Godzilla is handled in this new movie, as it feels a lot more like the God Soldier short that both Anno and Higuchi worked on, and concluded by stating that he really enjoyed the film and that it had a far more coherent plot than 2014's Godzilla. Marcus Go from Yahoo felt that the film was a better reimagining than 2014's Godzilla, though he criticized parts of Godzilla's design and the protagonist's plan to stop Godzilla. Hawkinson praised the film's battle scenes, Shiro Sagisu's score, and the film's homages to the franchise, and concluded that Shin Godzilla may be a reboot sans the rubber suit we've grown to love, but it's unquestionably Godzilla. At the time, Higuchi noted that Legendary's contract was effective until 2020. After Shin Godzilla, Toho produced a trilogy of anime Godzilla films, Godzilla, Planet of the Monsters, Godzilla, City on the Edge of Battle, and Godzilla, The Planet Eater, BD 89860990 84.